So for this research project, I picked Donald Milton McAlpine. He was born in 1934 in, probably gonna say this wrong, Quandiala, New South Wales in Australia. He was a PE instructor and he used to film the athletes that were getting ready for the Melbourne Olympic Games. And what he did was he used to film everything and then after that analyze everything, their moves and all that stuff. That's how he kind of like started getting good at the using the camera and all that stuff. And then one day his school went on a field trip to ABC, and that is Australian Broadcasting Commission Television. And so the school went there, he was there also, and that's when he found the news office. He went inside and he told one of the people that worked there, well, hey, if I get the end of the world on film, would you buy it? And they asked him, are you any good? And he said, who knows? So what they did was they gave him a paper with instructions and rules on how to film the right way for the news. They gave him some equipment with the paper with the rules and instructions on how to do it, and told him that when he was finished, he could return and they will evaluate everything that he did. Anyway, that's exactly what he did. He went back to the office, he showed them his work, and they liked it. And he started with freelancing, and eventually he got he actually started working for the company. And then obviously, well, he started doing movies in Australia, and after three of his film were released, I'm gonna put them right there so you can see it. After those three movies were released, this director, I'm gonna read it right now, Paul Mazursky, noticed his work and offered him a chance to travel to Greece where they were gonna film the movie Tempest. And after that successful movie, he started to work in the United States too. That's how everything like came to place. He was born in 1934, so back then somebody asked him like recently, where did you study? And he said that he was self-taught, because back then there was no film school where he needed it or when he needed it. So he's one of those cinematographers that got to learn as he went. And yeah, so he didn't go to school for that. He just learned and did it. He has a lot of movies and I will put them there or wherever. But here are my favorite ones. He got Moulin Rouge in 2001, The Chronicles of Narnia, The Lion, The Witch, and The Wardrobe. This was released in 2005. We got The Ender's Game in 2013, Predator in 1987, The Dressmaker in 2015, Mrs. Doubtfire in 1993, Peter Pan 2003, My Brilliant Career in 1979, Mental in 2012, Stepmom in 1998, and The Time Machine in 2002. Those are my favorite ones because I feel that that's in those movies you can actually see his technique in everything he does, that it is what I like. Well, I did my research and I looked and I didn't find anything specific that he does different from other people. But one thing that I found, he's very versatile and he does any kind of genre. And so he doesn't stop and does one type of movie. He just does any type. So yeah, I like how versatile he is. Another thing I like about him is the way he uses light and the camera angles and movements to like to make people's emotion, like the character, to show their emotions the way it's supposed to be. That's one of my favorite things that I noticed that he does. He plays really well with the lights. He's not like super awesome at this thing or only at that thing. He's like an overall very good cinematographer, and I think that's why he's been so successful, because he was born a long time ago, so he had all this time to learn, mess up, and right now he just does and deliver what he needs to do. I think that like I just said, his major thing is his experience. He started very early, so he gained a lot of experience. He's a very good example of what a cinematographer does. And so, yeah, I think that's his influence on cinematography. And then on me, what I like about him is that he really didn't have to, he didn't go to school. He just learned as he went. He made some mistakes, he learned from that, and he kept going. And I like that I have seen throughout the class the different type of ways of approaching this media and film and video production world. And I see that there's so many different ways to go. Like from the very beginning where the guy was saying like a PA and giving coffee or whatever, and some other people started doing their own videos, their own little short clips, movies. So I like that he's a very good example of how you can just make it if you really want to do it. So that's his influence on me. He just kind of like pushes me to just continue doing what I'm doing. Just record things like one of your guests said. Just record, film here, film there, edit, put it together. And like eventually the more practice and more experience that you get, obviously you'll get better. And yeah, so that's what it is. And then for the awards, I'm gonna have them somewhere in there too, so you can see the big list, but I only picked the most important ones for me. He got the Australian Film Institute Award for Best Achievement in Cinematography for My Brilliant Career 1979 and Bricker Morant in 1980 or 81. And then 1981, he got Cinematographer of the Year. In 1997, he had an Award of Distinction. In 2008, he got an International Achievement Award. And then he got, I don't have the date of this, but he got an AACTA Award, Raymond Longford Award. This is from Australia. He was awarded the Australian Centenary Medal in 2001. In 2001, Queen's New Year Honours List for his services to Australian society and Australian film production. A little reminder of the cinematographer or the director of photography does. He's a person in charge of shooting the film, and he's the head of the camera and lighting departments. So here in Moulin Rouge, my favorite thing is just how saturated the colors are, how bright everything is. But at the same time, how soft the light hits their faces when they're inside the room and outside the room.
But it's the best I can do.
Naughty! Don't stop! Yes! Yes! Yes!
My gift is my soul. And this one's for you. And you can tell everybody that this is your song. I hope you don't mind that I put down in words how wonderful life is. Now you're in the world.
Here on Peter Pan, the saint and the use of lights on their faces and the close-ups.
She told him stories. He taught her to fly. How?
You just think happy thoughts. They lift you into the air.
Yeah, so the close-up of them two right here and the light, the way it reflects on them, the way it hits on them. Here, a different angle from the top, now from the bottom. And now from the top again. Right here, a little showing her feet, letting you know that she's about to fall.
this is my brilliant career, and he won an award with this movie. Oh! Here we can see him, like, zooming in on her. And then it's going to cut to her doing that with her hands. Like a cutaway insert. And then zooms out as he moves the camera.
81, 82, 83, 84.
Here, like, the contrast of the colors. And also the importance of the objects, how he cuts away and shows that. And then this one right here, too. In Stepmom, I like the basic camera movements and shots that they show. Here's an establishing shot where the stepmom is going to go meet the mom. They're going to have a meeting shot of the mom just waiting for the stepmom to come in. And they show her. Now the camera is going to move to keep them both in the same frame. Here's showing the POV of this guy looking to see what's going on when he realizes there's a bear coming to get him. And then I like the shakiness of the camera, how it moves to let you know that there's something serious going on, that this bear is about to eat this guy. And now a little reel that I found on YouTube.